Hello friends, welcome to the channel Physics by IITians. Today we are discussing some of the previous year problems from GATE exam. These problems are also helpful for your other exams like NET, TIFR and all. So let's discuss these problems. These are mathematics problems and I have taken two topics. One is complex number and another is differential equation. Let's start with the complex number problem. The question is to integrate the integration 5z cube plus 3z square divided by z square minus 4. And you have to integrate it over the circle mod of z minus 1.5 equal to 1. So this is the contour integration of question. And for this, firstly we need to draw this circle. So this is the complex plane. Here we are having real part of z and this is the real imaginary part of z. We can see that this circle has a center at z equals to 1.5. So this is the center and the radius of this circle is 1 as given here. So this is the circle. Now this function can be written as this. I have taken the products z square minus 4 as factorized z minus 2 and z plus 2. From this denominator we can find the poles. Poles of this this function will be z equals to 2 and z equals to minus 2. Out of these poles you can see that this z equals to minus 2, that is the point here, is outside this circle. So we can ignore this point. We will just include the pole at z equals to 2. So now the method is to find the residue. For finding the residue, we will simply write that limit z tending to 0, the poles, that is limit z tending to 2, z minus 2 times f of z. Here f of z is given to you. So you can simply write the residue at R1, that is limit z tending to 2. This z minus 2 factor will cancel with this denominator z minus 2 factor. So we will have limit as 5z cube plus 3z square divided by z plus 2. And if we put this limit in this function, so we will have residue at z equals to 2 as 13. Now using the Cauchy-Riemann equation, we can say that the integration of this particular function will be 2 pi I times summation of all the residues. And residues is only 1, so the answer will be 2 pi I times 13, so your answer will be 26 pi I term. Next question is from differential equation and the question is given as d2fx by dx square minus 2dfx by dx plus fx equal to 0. In this, the boundary conditions are given to you as f0 equal to 1 and f1 equals to 0 and we have to find the function value at x equal to 0.5. Firstly, we can assume that this d by dx is capital D. So this differential equation can be rewritten as d square minus 2d plus 1 f of x equal to 0 and from this equation we can find the auxiliary equation, that is putting d equals to m, so equation will be m square minus 2m plus 1 equal to 0 and if we find the roots of this auxiliary equation, as this is a m minus 1 whole square equation, the roots will be only 1 and 1, so there are two equal roots. For equal root condition, we have the general solution of fx as c1 plus c2x times e to the power x. If these roots are different, like suppose roots are a1 and a2, then the solution will be c1 e to the power a1x plus c2 e to the power a2x, where c1 and c2 are constants. And a1 and a2 are the roots of this auxiliary equation. In this case, we get the function as fx equal to c1 plus c2x e to the power x. Now we can put the boundary conditions. If I put f of 0 equal to 1, so this condition will give us c1 equal to 1. Similarly, if you put the second boundary condition f of 1 equal to 0, then we will have c1 plus c2 times e equal to 0. So from here we can get that c2 will be equal to minus of c1, that is minus of 1. So all the constants c1 and c2 are now known to us. We can simply put these values in the function equation. So we will have the function fx as 1 minus x times e to the power x. So this is our final answer. Now we want to find the value of this function at x equal to 0.5. So we can simply put x as 0.5. So the answer will be 1 minus 0.5 e to the power 0.5. If we simplify this, the answer comes out to be 0.81. So this will be the final answer of this expression. Thank you friends. These are only two questions that we have discussed today. We will discuss more problems from the GATE exam and other exams in the coming videos. Thank you very much. If you like this video, please like this, share this and comment to this.